Okay, we're back on this Indian again, Native American, and this is what basically I'm looking for in this shirt. I always like the way they colored the top of the shirts and then sort of bled it out to the bottom down here. So that's what we're going to do first. I'm not going to make my shirt as blue as this one here, as I'd like to do the neckerchief a dark blue to contrast with that red blanket, okay? But this is basically where we're headed. All right. So he's looking good. So I'm going to take him apart here. Just lay this effort here out of the way. Take that off. Get him out of the way. Take this off. And water bottle. Let that soak in a bit. Okay, so tanned hide is basically, we'll start with this color here, raw sienna, all right? They used to make a color buckskin brown, but then, and I used it a lot, I really liked it. And then, like I've said before, you go down to buy some more and it's gone. Why? Don't ask me, I have no idea. Don't ask me. Alright, let's see. Still not using them new brushes. Okay. And again, I'm not concerned about slopping over paint on a lot of areas because it's going to be covered up by other colors. What I think I'm going to do is give me a little holder here. Oh, can't do that, can I? Nope. Can't do that. There's nothing to screw it into, so forget what I just said. I'm underpainting even the areas which are going to get those other colors because this tanned hide color will have a definite effect on the other colors that are going to go on top of it. Now I went down to buy my new brushes at Hobby Lobby. The last brushes I bought there were these Princeton brush, Elite brand, but again, like the paint, they didn't have them anymore. So I had to go for something else. Hopefully it'll be as good as these here. Squeeze me out a lot of paint there. This is a tan color called khaki. I don't know where they figure these names up. Khaki, that pretty well matches that. Some of these names they come up with. So you've got light blotches in here. That's what we're going to do. Got a little red in there too. This is burnt sienna. Okay, get a little straight red there. Fun. Excuse me. Starting up with avocado. Sort of a green. And we want it to come down about halfway. About there. Watch out. I like to wrap the colors around. the back, it just makes it a little cleaner than just coming up to the edge, because it would bleed and just not look good. Notice on the picture how the arms are blue. Oh, they go all the way down. Well, this is that arm there. And there you can see that brown coming through. That's what I mean about, you know, all colors were having an effect on each other. Alright, I'm going to squirt me out some blue here.
Didn't take much.
this and make it a little darker. It looks pretty good, I think. Really? Okay. Now for the red of the blanket. We want something really rich. Rookwood red. Let's take a look at that. I think that might be a nice undercolor. Squeeze out some of this here. Where will I put it? Take more of that, but we'll see what happens. I don't know what I can do. There we go. This is kind of a sick color by itself, but we're going to fix it. Red's kind of a color you have to watch out for, because if you happen to paint it in an area you don't want, it's hard to get rid of. The only thing that'll cover it up is gray. So if you get it in an area that you don't want, and you're having trouble with it, just paint that little area, or a big area, depending on what it is, with gray, and that'll get rid of it. Sounds crazy, but it's the only color that works. I'm going to let Judy's arms rest holding that camera, so we'll be back here once I get this all painted with this color. Okay, we got our underpayment on. Now, the underpayment, red, what? I underpaint certain colors because the color I want is not strong enough by itself. By underpainting, you're going to give that color a base to really come out. Like if I wanted yellow, this color, and I put that on a piece of wood there, it would just look sick. So I underpaint it with yellow ochre, which is a really strong, a much stronger color, and it's not near as transparent, if at all, as this one here. And it works out real well. So now that we've got our undercoat on, we're going to come back with a fairly rich red. This is Moroccan red. I like it. It's a rich, rich red. We'll see what that looks like here. Yeah. Let's try to stay within my lines, but if I happen to go out, remember that other color is going to be black, so it will probably be covered, but I still try to stay in my line. And again, give Judy a break. She can go sit down while I paint this all over again. All right, I got it all painted. You can see that the color is getting really, really rich. What I'm going to do is take just a little bit of blue. More than that. And run. Pretty good. And as the last thing, let's see here. I'm going to take this real bright red. Thank you. That looks pretty good. Sure made it rich looking, didn't it? So we had, what, 1, 2, 3, 4 colors on there to get that red we wanted. Now, I want some black or licorice. Black, isn't it? When you're see how that little tip on there curls one way? It'll always curl that way.
It's black on black. It's black there.
See how it curls? Curls up there, curls down when I twin, but it'll never change. So you have to learn to use it to your advantage. So I want to aim it into that line. If I turned it over the other way, like this, I wouldn't have any control over it, really. So I'll just aim it into that line. And it does what I want it to do. Just did the opposite there than what I told you earlier, didn't I? But that's okay. Not every situation is the same. Sometimes they are, but a lot of times they're not. So you just have to go with the flow. I could also use a smaller brush, but I'm almost just about done here. I kind of hold my breath while I do this. A sigh of relief. Now even this black or licorice has a transparent factor, so we want to get it as much on there as we can, like that. So now what I'm going to do, let's see here. Not that color. Where it sticks up, usually in the middle. I'm going to kind of make it a little lighter. Maybe not that light, but get as much water out of my brush as I can. Forgot about that area right there. Get rid of one and create another one. There we go. Now that looks pretty good. That's going to do it for this video, but I just wanted to get these main colors laid down. Looking good, I think. Let's just take a quick gander here just to see. Get in trouble when I do this. I'm just so damn impatient, as Judy always tells me. That's enough. Let's just take a peek to see what it looks like. I think that looks good. Looking good. Okay. All right. So, till next time, which will be pretty quick because I'd like to get this done. I'll talk to you later.